representing the councillor for a to encourage bana ba rona gore they choose the right career le gore education e vital le futo ba bontsha gore re ba supporta in all aspects relating to their education.
Solo money,
solo money.
From Sishambu Community Station, the sports presenter, as a sports button, Ibile, director or CEO of the Mesmutang Foundation, Ibile, happy to be with you. Ibile, the HIV activist, survivor, yeah, rape, TB, and cancer, all those stuff. Kitlemo career, expo, because I want to motivate kids. I to hurry. Sugar daddy life, I reckon. Now, but I told you, Musola, how fate is society? Your
social movement. Rena mo le bo mme ba di eme re thetha bana ba rena ka lebaka la roka tseno is a big day for bloko ya rena ya di eme rena le career expose ka tseno mo di eme mo blok mo mo social nge mo di eme ka mola bona ba rena bona ba tsi ka motenteng ka mola ba busy ba empower ba ba bontsha ka mokgwa education e leng important ka teng. So re re halala di eme
halala
solilwela
izela.
Izwela me Izwela me regla mo poco ve tumbo si olilwe lawo yo Izwela me Izwela me regla mo poco ve
yakuleva kuwe nkosi sikhibaya ke nkosi yesu.
Coach Nathan Dobu, I'll be officiating the program of today. I welcome you all. I'm sorry. I would like to apologize.
But I won't waste your time. So, firstly, kitonyaka Mr. Maluleke, atoro bulela kathape. So I would like to briefly explain why we are here. Kajeno event ya rena ke Career Expo. Career Expo Block M Social Group Block M Youth Forum. E bone ho le necessary hore re host a Career Expo hore re tlo kgona go thusa young people ba o tshwana le nna ka information as to which career path tse di meetang the qualities tsa bona and strength. So hona ya nongo ke tlo kopela Mr. Mabudu a dira welcome.
Is this side? Professor Gumbu, you are welcome. I would like to also acknowledge within our midst, Mr. Maphosa is a professor. Also, he's from the very same institution. Mr. Maphosa is Professor Maphosa from UNISA also. You are welcome, sir. I will also like to acknowledge the presence of TUT reps within our midst, the presence of South African Police Service Forensic Unit within our midst. They are that side. I will also maybe lastly to acknowledge the presence of our motivational speaker. Those who are going to motivate our youth, those who are going to guide us, as what they do and they don't. You are welcome, motivational speakers. And I further want to acknowledge the presence of all professionals from different fields. Because if I'm going to mention the names of those fields, I can do that until the sunset, and I don't want to waste time since we are already in time. You know, the residents of Block M, they felt that crime is on hostage, well, it's not hostage, on rampage. And then when we discussed the issues on crime, we noticed that this crime is not committed by adult people. We notice that our youth, our children, they are the perpetrators. They are those who are committing these different types of crime within our community. It's therefore our youth decided to come up with the idea to host this type of an event. Why? As parents, we would like to take these kids out of the streets. We want to actually guide our kids into a right path. Because while they're out there, you know, we call the Chomi. Because Chomi Aga is doing this, my friends is doing that. Therefore, then now I need to do what. And we also realize that if we can invite professionals from different fields, those professionals will be in the position to help you guys, our kids, as to which careers our children can take. Because, you know, our kids are very much lazy sometimes. Kids, they like to just to follow what their friend is doing. You may find that because the friend is doing policing career, the friends will like to follow that. And then at the end of the day, after they graduated, they are not getting employment. And then we as parents, we keep on saying, yeah, this government is not assisting us. Our kids are so well educated, they are not getting employment. That is the challenge. And the challenge is not from the government only. We must not put the challenge on the side of the government. We, as parents, we must also account to that. Because we pay to guide our kids to choose the correct careers. I would like to give you an example. In most of the time, if you can go to this academical institution, you will find that our kids are taking careers like correctional services, SAPS, metro policing, traffic. And then, you know, it's a pity because this institution, according to me, or according to my observation, or my stupid research, maybe, so to say, they are after the money. They just to see collecting monies, not guiding these kids to say, are you from SAPS? Are you from traffic environment? Are you from correctional services? They are not doing that. And then our kids, they keep on studying, graduating until they get PhD or whatever. And then only to forget that those careers or those purposes, they are meant for people who are within that particular field, those which I mentioned. And then except other than that, our specialists, our academics here, they will assist maybe to guide our kids as to which career path they came for. Without wasting any time, Mr. MC, we are behind time now. I thank you for everything. I thank everybody here. I think and I hope that you are going to enjoy it. Thank you.
One of our dedicated parents. In everything that involves the community, he is always there. In everything that concerns the community, be it crime or anything, he is always there. This is one of the most dedicated parents. Thank you. Ketobita Me Shofi Malema from the council.
Destroying everything.
I'm standing here on behalf of Councillor Warrena, Ward 35, Iling Councillor Popi Maseka. First and foremost, I'd like to say to the youth organized in this thing, for one, time is money. Two, you are working towards building a long-lasting reputation. So not keeping time takes it all away from you. So let me get to the real business now. I'd like to welcome the opportunity therefore you have invited us here. I need to tell you this. The councillor asked me to come and stand here on her behalf at a very short notice because she's got other obligations. And then when she told me this has got to do with the career expo, I thought I should impart the following information to you. The world has so many lessons to teach you, and now I'm talking to the youth. I consider this world, this earth, to be like a school, and our life is the classroom. And sometimes here in the, on this planet earth, which is the school, the lessons often come dressed up as detours and or roadblocks, and sometimes as full-blown crises. And the secret I've learned to getting ahead is being open to the lessons. Lessons from the grandest university of all, that is the universe itself. Until you know that before you get into class, you still have to learn life lessons. Only then will you become successful. So today, the youth here, Block M, I want to share with you three lessons that I've learned in my journey so far. And by the way, I'm 50 years old, so you should know that the journey has been long. These lessons have had the greatest impact on my life, and they have to do with feelings, with failure, and finding happiness. Now, we are starting with the first lesson, being feelings. How do you know when you are doing something right? Just how do you know that? If it's right, it will feel right. What I know now is that feelings are really the GPS system for life. The same way as location. GPS again. We look at a map as a youth. So the feelings somehow, it's a GPS system. When it doesn't feel right, don't do it. And that lesson alone will save you a lot of grief. Even doubt means don't. How doubt our morale? It's in ish more ukarpia fambol. Because it's not right. When you get still and let your internal motivation be the driver, not only will your personal life improve, but it will gain you a competitive edge in the world of education. Don't try to be popular. Always try to do the right thing. So lesson one, follow your feelings. If it feels right, move forward. If it doesn't feel right, don't do it. That's my lesson. If you have a little doubt at anything that your friends or anybody says you must do, and you feel then don't do it. And then now we're talking about failure. Nobody wants to get into a marriage at the house. You always strive for perfection. But because I'm going to read it as clearly understand it as you. Nobody's journey is seamless or smooth. We all stumble. We all have setbacks. If things go wrong and you hit a dead end, and definitely believe you me, you will. It's just life's way of saying to you, it's time to change course. We try to change a direction or change a plan. And I want to give you tip when I face failure, what do I do? I speak to the failure itself. I ask the failure, what is it that you want to teach me as failure? When now or in crisis or difficulty in my life, what is it that you want to do?
And as soon as I get the lesson, then I move on. But then, if you really get the lesson, you will pass. And you don't have to repeat the class. Again, remember I said life, university is the university. If you don't get the lesson, it shows up again. And if you ignore it, you repeat that class, you fail, you repeat. But then still, you need to persevere so that you should emerge more resilient with the knowledge that you have conquered the fear. And then my final lesson, the happiness. And we can continue to talk about happiness for the whole day. Happiness is about being part of something. Don't live for yourself alone. This is what I know for sure. In order to truly be happy, you must live along with, and you have to stand for something larger than yourself. Because life is a reciprocal exchange. To move forward, you have to give back. And to me, that is the greatest lesson of life. To be happy, you have to give something back. You need people so that you help people to those that are that happy. And on that note, I'd like to say to you, on behalf of our Honorable Councillor Poppy Maseka, I wish you success with this career expo, and I wish that you choose the right career and you choose the right path. You have Councillor Poppy Maseka's unequivocal support in anything and everything positive that you wish to do more Block M. I thank you.
If it feels right,